Yo, what's the deal? Boom, 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 boom. What's up? What's up, Jazz? Kilo, what up? Kirk. Jay. We live, baby. Mall back. Hold on 1 second. Ew. Play some bangers really quick. Don't you open up that window. Man, I drank too much water, to be honest. Way too much water. Sloan and Bennett. Bacardi. almost. I definitely feel like I got a beard going here. Struggle beard, but definitely doing some stuff. I hope everybody had a good day. We're gonna do some fun stuff today. Got my very special friend, Taylor Rooks, talented Taylor Rooks, busy lady. She just got through doing a live with Kari Champion. You know, representing brown girls, giving some positive advice. But my approach today is gonna be a little looser, a little fun. Get to find out a little bit more about Taylor. How she grew up. I hope everybody enjoy. There we go. What's up, girly? There we go.
Hello.
What's going on? How you doing?
How are you?
I'm good. Finally.
I have to warn you, I'm a little tipsy from that live because we were drinking all this wine. Okay, good. I'm all out though. I have champagne. I'm gonna pour.
Whatever you need to, you know, before we start, you know, we're in a rush.
Oh, I'm loose. I'm ready.
All right, perfect. You know, I had a little music, but I was just telling them that you were on Kari Champion's Instagram live.
Yes, it was so much fun. She's great.
Yeah, I caught the last 5 minutes of it. So I don't know if you got a chance to catch me in the last episode. We do a segment mm-hmm. before we start called One of the Two by Jason Madison. You know, he threw this in there. So I'm going to throw some rapid fire questions. You got to pick and choose before we dive into growing
okay.
up thing. All right. Hip hop or R&B?
R&B.
Okay. Brandy or Monica?
Brandy.
Beyonce or Rihanna?
Why are you doing this to me?
It's fun.
Rihanna.
Okay. Microwave or oven?
Oven.
Best man or the wood?
The wood.
Okay. Sweats or shorts?
Sweats. Sweats on right now.
Cozy girls. Menace to Society or Boys in the Hood?
Boys in the Hood.
Okay. iced coffee or hot coffee?
No coffee.
Perfect. I'm a tea person too. Pharrell or Kanye?
Pharrell.
Music or food?
Food.
Falcons or the Falcons. Illini? Over Falcon. School? All right, bet. Chicken or steak?
Chicken. I don't eat beef or pork.
All right. Yeah. Well, that. Thank you for doing the one or two. That was really quick. All right.
Well, you said rapid fire. I was like, I gotta.
Yeah. No. Definitely. That's what I was. That was what I was more so expecting. So we're just gonna jump right into this. Growing up the same pod, obviously. You know, I'm much older than you. What, you're 92?
92. How old are you?
I am 35.
That's not much older.
It's not much older, but 85 and 92, I was 7. But
okay.
Black don't crack. Give me my credit.
You look great. Yes, I'm 27, but I'll be 28 next month.
All right. So, we got a chance to chat over some relatable content, you know. And the first one that stuck out was shopping malls. Mm-hmm. Tell me how important shopping malls were to you as a adolescent.
They're so important. I would always, so obviously be at school, it'd be Friday. It's like, what do you guys want to do this weekend?
Mm-hmm.
Everyone would just say, let's go to the mall. Like, let's walk around the mall, because you knew everyone was walking around the mall. So you'd walk around, try to be cute, and you'd run into people from school like, oh, hey, what are you doing here? Right. Occasionally we'd see a movie while at the mall, but it was really just walking. There was a cute boy that like everyone at the school liked that worked at one of those kiosks, you know what I mean? That's like in the middle of the mall. So that's what we did, honestly, every single weekend.
So was this in St. Louis or Atlanta? Like in
this was Georgia. In Georgia. So
it's in Georgia. I've so lived... what mall did you hang out at the most?
Discover Mills.
Okay.
It's in Gwinnett County. I'm from Gwinnett County. Suburbs. All right.
So, you're familiar with, well, you went to the same high school as Lou?
No, but he was very close to me. Lou went to South Gwinnett.
Okay.
I went to Peachy Ridge. So, and my high school was like Bradley Roby.
Okay.
Cam Hayward. Right down the street was like Jeremy Lamb.
Okay.
Lou was right down the street too. Berkmar, where the Migos went, like that was right down the street.
Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. Okay. So yeah, my experience was a little different. Obviously, I didn't hang out in the malls too much. I normally would go to the malls to go buy the Jordans on Wednesdays. That's when the Jordans that explained a lot. When Jordans were coming out on school days, I would ditch, mm-hmm. go get my Jordans, and then come back to school and wear them.
Yeah.
But you know, that was a cool experience. And then one of my malls, I'm from the east side near mm-hmm. you know, I'm from Compton, but one of our popular malls was Lakewood Mall.
Okay.
And, I would go to Lakewood Mall a lot and buy video games and a bunch of stuff, but I didn't walk around that much, you know what I mean? Like, I had everything in my neighborhood.
It was like it would be like, okay mom, if you take us, her parents will pick us up,
right?
You
all had the plans.
But growing up, I was very, 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 very into Harry Potter, and I still am. Like, I love Harry Potter. And so at the mall, there was a store called Books A Million, and what we would do whenever there was a new book coming out, I would go to the party that you stayed all night, and then at midnight, you could buy the book.
Okay.
So I was like at the mall for every big thing that like meant a lot to me, whether it was walking around with friends, whether it was books I liked, whether it was once a week, my dad and I would go to that mall to go see a movie. The mall was like a big part of the way that I grew up.
Now you probably going to boo me, but I haven't gotten to the Harry Potter wave. I'm behind on that. But
have you really seen the movies?
Nah. So now I have time to catch up. So I'm going to dive back in. And I'm
no, you have to. Yes.
All right. So next thing. Bike riding. How mm-hmm. important bike riding was to you?
That was all I did. Went around the neighborhood, rode around the cul-de-sacs, knocked on everyone's door. Y'all want to ride bikes? I was also big into the Razor scooter.
Oh, Razor scooter was amazing. It was definitely one of the staples in the hood and everywhere, honestly. But
yeah.
if you didn't like have it on the ground and you were like trying to carry it, it actually could hit your foot. Or your ankle area, because the bottom was swing, like that was awful.
Yeah.
I had a cool bike with pegs. I would try to do tricks and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And then just, you know, I had a few boys that we would we would ride all over the place and ride areas we weren't supposed to ride, but bike riding was still important. I just got a bike like 2 weeks ago, so I'm trying to get back.
Oh, good that. For you. No, I loved riding bikes, and I thought I was like such a mechanic when the thing would come off, you know, the chain.
The chain, yeah.
I would like have to fix it. I'm like, all right, here I go. Like,
you had them oily ass hands. You wasn't getting these yet. You had the oily hands changing it.
I loved it.
All right. The next topic we got is AIM. What was your screen name?
Taylor Baby 2006.
Taylor Baby 2006.
And I had the most dramatic away messages.
Like, was it inspired by R&B songs? Did you just feel like your heart was just getting broken?
It would be songs. It would be dramatic quotes. It would be, you know how people would do the art, like, to make a heart. You know what I mean?
Right.
I was doing the most on AIM.
So you had the Unicodes going, and you was one of them people. So, if you push one character wrong, the heart gonna be crooked.
Yes, Pat. Or it would be like, I would be like, all right, out, make it vibrate, and my phone number. It was so stupid.
Oh, shit. See, when I was on AIM, I remember going to a basketball workout, and I came back and I looked at everybody's away message, and everybody said, "Damn, Kobe, this is the night he scored 81." And I'm just sitting there like, No. This is a mistake. Y'all must mean like he had 18 or something like that. Everybody stuff said, "Damn, Kobe." And then my AIM name was it was the Schoolboy. That was my first one, inspired by Murphy Lee. I had Zero to Hero, which was another one. And then the last one was Black Trey, and that's how Black Trey stuck.
I had Taylor Baby 2006 was like my one in, when I was older, but my very first, so embarrassing, my very first one was like X Poppin' My Collar X. Like, it was stupid. Because, so you have to also remember, I absolutely grew up in like MySpace era.
Okay.
So.
Oh no, I was grown MySpace though. That was the only thing.
Different MySpaces.
Okay.
Yeah. But my era, it was like, you know, you had the song when you went to the page. And at one time, my song, that when you went to my page, was popping my collar. Once it was Party Like a Rock Star. It was Travis Porter.
That's a great song. Shop boys don't get their flowers.
They don't. They really don't. And Travis Porter doesn't get their flowers either. And like growing up in Georgia, Travis Porter was very, very big. To us, they had a lot of hits. And so my song was always Travis Porter. Like Travis Porter was kind of.
Oh, so you were at the parties dancing, huh?
I was.
All
right. I was doing the most when I was in high school, though. So when I was 15,
okay,
I went into a garage and got 3 tattoos.
Just getting after it.
There I was go. Like, listen, this is what we're
I didn't
doing.
Get my first. I didn't get my first one until I was 20. I was scared. My grandma.
Good for you. I should have waited.
My grandma didn't. She was a little woman, but she scared me. And I just, you know, one time I came home with the tattoos. I got out the shower, and she seen them. I slipped up, and she was like, "Don't get no more." I came back home again. I had probably like 20 tattoos after that. So,
oh no!
Yeah, it hasn't stopped. So I'm just trying to.
Yeah, you know, I was in trouble forever.
But definitely a fun time. So I got some more questions from our director, South Central Jay.
Hi, South Central Jay.
Okay. Who has been your favorite interview?
Favorite because of what? Like favorite because of the conversation?
Just the conversation in general. Like, you know, probably since you had your platform, you know, or.
Well, I think everybody thinks of the Michael Beasley interview.
Okay.
Just because it was so wild. I don't know if that's my favorite, but it was definitely the most viral, like when he was talking about the brain and stuff. Oh, shout out, It's the Real. It was definitely It's the Real. I think favorite for me, I think about my show. I think my best work I've done on the show was probably the DeMar DeRozan interview.
Okay. Shout out to Compton.
Shout out to Compton. He actually had on like a Compton.
Yeah, that's, we're looking out for that too. We got some merch, COMP10.
I'd say DeMar DeRozan or Chris Paul. Also, I love when I get to work with my friends. You know, Saquon is one of my best friends in the world, and I get to interview him often. Mm-hmm. So that's one of my favorites. But I think as far, in terms of work, probably DeMar DeRozan and Chris Paul.
Okay.
People are saying the KD interview, that was another one of my favorites. I've known KD for 10 years now, so anytime I get to interview him, it's cool. Our careers kind of, like, grew together. That's the thing. I don't know if I had the interview that I'm like, this is the best, and I'm happy about that because that means that it's coming and there's something to look forward to.
Absolutely. I definitely enjoyed the Michael Beasley. My man pulled up with the two watches.
Yeah, he did.
That was a sicker man move right there. I don't know too many people that can pull off two watches. Who did you look up to in broadcasting?
I mean, I look up to so many people for different reasons, you know. Pam Oliver was the first Black woman I saw on TV talking about sports. So Pam, for sure.
Shout out to Pam Oliver.
Carrie Champion is like my heart, my friend, my mentor. I love her. She's just great on television. She's just natural on television. I think Rachel Nichols asks amazing questions. She asks great questions. Honestly, one of my favorites. He's a bit too shock jockey for me, but he's great at his job, as Howard Stern. Howard Stern is
phenomenal. That's the funny thing about it. Jason just literally just mentioned about the Howard Stern effect on this, trying to go in that direction. But he is one of the early favorites, definitely.
Yeah, Howard Stern is fantastic. I mean, yeah, there's so many. Those are probably the ones that stick out the most. And, yeah, someone said Terry Gross. Love Terry Gross. I did book recommendations on my story the other day, and I have her book. It's great. She wrote a book called All I Did Was Ask. And she transcribes some of her favorite moments from interviews and all those things, and it's a good read for anybody who wants to be a journalist or interviewer or whatever the case may be.
Okay. Do you feel more or less respected as a female anchor?
I mean, more. I feel respected all the time because I'm to be respected.
Yeah.
But I think that with anything that women do, they're almost always seen as women first. Mm-hmm. And as much as I draw so much strength and purpose from my femininity, I think that it'll be great when it comes a time where it's like everybody is just in the business and it's not always like this is a female reporter, female anchor, female host, whatever the case may be, because I think that when you put that word before someone else, you see them as that mainly. And as much as I want to be seen as a woman, I want to be seen as a worker, and I want to be seen as somebody who is really, really good at their job. But I think any person who doesn't respect a female in this business that has so much more to do with them than it does any of us. And I don't know if you've ever read The Four Agreements, but one of the things is don't take anything personally. So I don't really care if anybody has an opinion of me that is not an opinion that I have of myself. But I mean, it's no secret that being a woman in this business is 10 times more difficult than being a man in this business.
Right.
But that's because of other people, not because of us.
Okay. What's your favorite film?
So honestly, I'm more of a TV person than I am a film person.
Okay.
But film, that's so hard. I know for sure, easily my favorite show of all time is The Wire.
Okay.
For my favorite film.
I'm glad you actually watched that, because a lot of people haven't.
Oh my God, I'm obsessed. But film? Mm-hmm. Honestly, I don't know. Truly, make up an answer.
Okay.
I have films I like. I love Love Jones.
Great movie. I didn't like the cigarettes, but it's a great movie.
I love
that's what my hair look like right now. I'm looking like Brother of the Night for sure.
Hey, Brother of the Night was fine. So
hey, it's all right. It's all right. It's all right. I'll be okay.
I love Paid in Full. I love The Prestige. I love I love a lot of movies. I don't know, but I'm definitely more of a TV gal.
Okay. All right. What movie or TV character do you relate to the most? I'm Larry David right now. I'm Larry David, Curb, for
That's
sure.
That's so funny. Larry David's a good one. I think I relate to Wendy from Billions.
Hey, Wendy is tough.
Fucking love Wendy. Ooh, I cuss.
We all right. We're good. I just might have bleep it.
People guys. Wendy from Billions for sure. I think I relate to. I relate to Nina Mosley from Love Jones. I'm very much so, like, I always say, like, I belong in, like, the 90s. Like, I love her simple aesthetic. She's very classic. She's minimalistic. She's pure. She's soft. She's kind. She's warm. I just love Nia Long in general. But no, I feel like I relate a lot to Wendy. From Billions.
Okay, that's a great character. Fresh Prince or Martin?
I have pictures of both in my apartment.
Okay.
I hate this question because I love them both so much. But if I
nobody's not going. Martin Lawrence not going to unfollow you.
I'm gonna say Martin.
It's a great show. It's relatable to life stuff, right? Unless you're not paying the five.
I think that I probably relate more to Fresh Prince, but I like Martin more.
Okay, that makes sense. All right, if you could only watch one show for the rest of your life, what would it be?
The Wire,
okay. Yeah. If you could relive any memory from childhood, what would it be?
I don't know, probably any time with my grandparents. They've passed and I was close to them, so maybe any time with them. My grandma, my grandpa, my mom's side.
Okay. That's a great answer. And what's the best sporting event you ever covered?
Big Ten Championship 2015. It was Ohio State versus Wisconsin. It was the first year of a college football playoff. I was on the field. Ohio State won 59-0, and they went on to win the first ever college football playoff, and it was the craziest game. It was just cool to see their journey from start to finish.
Okay.
This is when I was at the Big Ten Network.
What was the last book you read?
I'm reading books right now. But the last book that I read was Normal People by Sally Rooney.
Okay. All right. And my last question.
What Jim's in here. Hi, Jim Ice.
Jim Ice. Ice baby. What up? What advice would you give 18-year-old Taylor?
Means so much.
So think it through. Think it through, because Jerry, he put the pressure on a lot of people. He got some solid.
What was his?
Don't loan money. That was the first thing.
That's so funny. Well, my no, I'm not gonna say that. I think I'm thinking of what 18-year-old Taylor was doing. Right, 18-year-old Taylor was. Sophomore in college, trying to figure it out, working in sports. I think I had done my first broadcast by then. I think I'd probably say don't let people put you into a box.
Mm-hmm.
I think that when I very first started out in this business, you think that you have to act like what a journalist acts like. And when you do that, you take away a lot of your power and a lot of what makes you, like, special and unique.
Yeah.
And then through time, I was like, the reason I'm here is because I'm myself. So I just want to act like me and not be, like, this robot person that's on television. Mm-hmm. I think when I was 18, I also cared a lot about what people thought about me.
Right.
Now I don't really care. But I think everybody who, I guess, does a job that's like in the public eye or whatever you want to call it in the beginning cares a lot about what people are saying. You want to tweet search yourself. You want to Google yourself. You want to see what's the word.
Right.
So I would tell 18-year-old Taylor that really doesn't matter. The only opinion that matters is with like people you care about and also like the higher ups. But it just doesn't, it doesn't matter. That's probably what I'm saying. And that you're absolutely limitless. You can do all the things that you want to do as long as you believe that, that you can do them.
Great answer. Well, Taylor, thank you so much. I wasn't trying to keep you up too late. I know you've been working all day.
Oh, no, you're fine. I'm chilling.
All right. Well, I appreciate it. And hopefully I can have you back on as a part two.
Yeah.
And I'll have some more fun questions.
No,
thank
these
you again.
Are great questions. I had fun.
I'm glad that you were able to join us.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me. I'll see you when we're on the other side of the pandemic.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Bye. Be safe. Bye.